If God answers though late, it will be powerful. It will be life-giving. It will be filled with hope. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Yes. The second spirit the enemy will attack is less disappointing spirit. The third spirit to take away your anointing, the enemy will attack is make you busy. Busy where? Like the busy bees are building up honeys. Satan will make you so busy that one who is too busy not to be with God, be sure your heart will lose His presence. If you don't have time for God, you will have time for nothing. Because all that is valuable comes from divine. Only from the light you can see things in the darkness. Without light, you will fall in darkness. Invest your time for God. The investing time for God will give you the light of God to see yourself and to see others and to walk in the right way. So your precious time, you are going to the office, just stop for a while. That's why Jeremiah says, if you don't want accident in your life, what you need to do? Three things. Jeremiah 6:16. Look at the another say. Do you know Jeremiah 6:16? It's not enough to become 16. Tell. You should know Jeremiah 6:16. If you don't want accident in your life, you need to do three things. Because the Father and the Son and the Spirit also three things. What are the three things? Number one, stop. Tell. Second, look around. Third, then proceed. Now place your hands over your heart. If you don't want accident in your life, you need to do three things. Number one, stop. Number two, look around. Look at yourself. Take time. Who are you? Who is your God? Why did He create you? What's happening to you? Why you are the child of God is disappointed? Why you have a great hope of God is angry and upset and yelling at each other? What's happening to you? Where are you going? Look into you. Look all around. Why are you breaking your cell phone? Why are you breaking the heart of your mother? Why are you throwing away the food which God has given to you? Look around. Take stock of your life. Retreat means take stock of who you are, what's happening to you. And then with the presence of the Holy Spirit, with the love, faith and hope, you have to retreat yourself. That is called retreat. Now take, ask the Lord to help you. Stop. Look around. Look inside you. Look around you. What do? What kind of life you are creating around you? What kind of family you are creating? What kind of, is it love, faith and hope or something else? Check your life, and after taking stock of your life, proceed in life. Ask the Holy Spirit to guide you. Invest time for God. Yes. With three or four jobs, you never become rich. You will earn money and you will use that money for your medicine. You are not earning money in your young age, running around in order to use them in your old age along with the pain. Invest your time for God. Carry His presence wherever you go, and His presence will carry you. Invest your time. Rejoice in Him. Take time to worship Him. Take time to thank Him. Take time to build up your mind. The best thing that God has given to build up your thoughts is through the thought of God, the word of God. Invest time to worship Him, to thank Him. Second, invest time to read the word of God. And let your mind be governed by the thinking and thoughts of God. Number three, learn to pray. Whatever may be your situation, whatever may be your problems, surrender to the Father. Surrender to God in prayer. Tell Him, Daddy, this is what I am going through. You said in 1 Peter 5:7, place all your worries upon the Lord. For you have a God who cares for you. I know, Daddy, that you care for me. But these are the worries come to me. These are the disappointments come to me. These are the things I am not able to do. These are the things I am not able to understand. I don't know. But I know that you are there for me. Place your hands over your heart and pray this little prayer, the prayer of the King Jehoshaphat in 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 12. Lord, the enemy who are coming against me look too numerous. Lord, the enemy that come against me look too numerous, and the mind of mine has become blackout. I do not know what to do with this situation, but one thing I can do, my eyes are looking towards you. Lord, my enemies are too many. Lord, I don't know what to do, but my eyes are upon you. Lord, na krodhamuga nilabeduthuna virodulu chaala mandi unnaru. Em cheyalo naku artham kavataledu, kaani na kannulu nee meeda unnai. Na kannulu nee meeda unnai. Take one more word to your heart. Psalm 25 verse 15, when my eyes are upon you, you free my feet from all its clutches. Na kannulu nee meeda undaga, na paadalanu chuttiyina bandhanala nundi neevu nannu vidippintu. When my eyes are upon you, your eyes are upon my feet and upon all that has been tied up at my feet. When my eyes are upon you, your eyes are upon my feet to free my feet. Lord, too many are the enemies. Lord, I don't know what to do. My mind is too small to think an answer, but my eyes are looking towards you. Invest your time to surrender all your prayers to the Lord. As Psalm 55 verse 22 says, place all your worries to God and your God will sustain you. When the current goes away, the battery sustains. Yes, prayer is your battery. When everything goes away, you cling on to your God. Place all your worries unto Him and He will sustain you. He will give you enough light, enough breeze for you to breathe, for you to walk, for you to do your work. He will take care of you. Everyone will die with hunger, even the king, but not the widow of Zarephath who trusts in God. God will send His prophet to you. God will feed you. Though you have only little flour, little oil, it will never go away. The flour will never go away. The oil will never go away until the rain comes. Until the land is filled with the food, God will sustain you. Invest your time. Satan will make you busy with one work, two work, three works, make you run after to earn money. Don't run around. The man who is too busy to invest time for God will be easily attacked by the enemy. But invest your time to praise God. To praise God. The people of the world, when they got bored up, they sing film song. But a man who is anointed worships. The people of this world sing songs. But anointed servant of God worships his God. Wherever he is, wherever she is, whether it is traveling in the bus, whether doing the work at computer, whether answering in the phone call, his mind and heart continues to vibrate. Thank you, my Father. I am your child. Lord Jesus, I am your child. Hold my hands. Surrender in prayer and continue to move on in life. God said to Elijah, get up, my son. I will anoint you. When I am anointing you, do you know what will come out of your about you? You will go down and anoint the king of Israel, the king of Samaria, and from you are going to anoint a servant called Elisha. From you, kings and prophets are going to be born. You are sleeping. Get up, my son. Get up. God has not given you the hope. God has not given you up. Why should you give up? Get up and walk in the anointing. And from you, kings and prophets are going to be born. Hallelujah. 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 Of course, the fourth one, Satan attacks to take away the anointing from you, is materialism, love for money.